Are you relatively new to exercise, or maybe you've been on a pursuit of fitness in the past, but just didn't quite accomplish the goals you wanted to? Well, the reason why I'm making this video is because I'm going to provide you with 10 tips that are guaranteed to help you achieve your goals in a timely and efficient manner. Tip number one. You've absolutely got to believe in yourself. And it starts all in here. If you don't believe in yourself, other people won't believe in you. And one of our other tips, we'll talk about why that's very important as well. You've got to realize that you're capable of great things. You're a strong, a powerful individual. And no matter what happens in life, you've got to be determined. You've got to tell yourself, you know what? I believe in me. I can do this. As long as you convince yourself of that, I'm telling you, those goals are yours for the conquering. Speaking of goals, tip number two, goal setting. Oftentimes in the fitness industry, we utilize what we call SMART goals. SMART is an acronym standing for specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and timely. When you come up with your goals, it's important that you think through those goals and make certain that they're going to be specific. So you don't want to just generalize. You want to make sure they're measurable. So you've got to have a way of gauging your progress, whether it's gaining weight, losing weight, building strength, whatever that may be. Attainable. We want to make sure that it's something that you can actually do. And that kind of ties directly into being realistic. So for example, let's say if I wanted to lose 60 pounds, it's not realistic for me to set a goal of losing 60 pounds in a 2-week period. And then timely. We've got to come to the point where we set a definitive time window. Otherwise, if I just say, hey, I want to lose 50 pounds eventually, it may take me forever to get it done. Tip number three, plan. Now that I have a goal in place, more specifically a SMART goal, I can now come up with a plan of attack. That plan is going to include things like, where am I going to work out? Do I have equipment at home? Am I going to get a gym membership somewhere? Maybe I'm going to hire somebody. It all depends. You also need to know how many times per week you're going to work out, the frequency, the intensity you plan on working out, the type of exercise you plan on doing. The exercise duration is important as well. I'll go into another video talking about the FIT principle, frequency, intensity, time, and type, and we'll kind of delve into that there. Tip number four, accountability. You absolutely have to be accountable to yourself. So you set a SMART goal, you've come up with a plan, and now it's time for you to be accountable. Now, do you recall earlier when I mentioned believing yourself was important so others would believe in you? Part of your accountability means establishing an accountability team. Those are going to be the individuals who make certain that you don't miss days at the gym, who make sure that you're logging your food, who call and check up on you, or whatever that looks like. But just make certain that under all circumstances, you remain accountable. Tip number five, and perhaps one of the most important tips when it comes to beginning a fitness journey, or for that matter, throughout your entire fitness journey, that is listen to your body. This is one of those things that I say to every single client the moment they walk in the door, before we have our very first session, I encourage them, listen to your body. And I explain that if, let's say you're doing a push-up and you get to the point where you notice some shoulder impingement or there's absolute pain or your shoulder just flat out hurts, that's a sign that something is wrong. That is a red flag. Your body is giving you that warning for a reason. So stop. If you're working with a trained professional, let them know what's going on. But you've got to listen to your body. Trust me, your body's lived with you all of your life. It knows you very well. Tip number six, safety first. You know, a lot of times people get excited about fitness journeys, and guys, I'm going to pick on you for a minute. Especially the men, they tend to want to load up the heavy weights, 200, 300, 400 pounds, lifting for ego. Getting results isn't always about lifting heavy. We have to prioritize safety with all things that we do. Make certain that safety is one of your top priorities. You've got to do it in a safe manner because the injury isn't going to do anything but set you back. Tip number seven, educate. And this can mean a lot of different things, but it's important that throughout this journey, you're constantly educating yourself. That could be reading books, reading blogs online. That can be talking to friends, qualified professionals. Maybe you have a background in kinesiology. That could be finding videos like this that give you great advice, great information, and clicking the like and subscribe button below to make certain that you see every video like this that I post for you. You've got to make certain that you're continuously on that pursuit to educate, because the better you educate yourself, the better you're going to be at taking care of yourself. Tip number eight, stretching and mobilizing. This may be one of the most overlooked components of a health and fitness journey. If you truly want to be healthy, you've got to incorporate stretching and mobilizing within your routine. As you continue to work and stress those muscles, they're going to get tight and they don't necessarily fully relax on their own. It is imperative that you stretch. As a general rule of thumb, your stretching duration should be at least 1 minute per muscle group or body part that's been worked. So for example, let's say if I worked my hamstrings and my quads today, I would want to make certain that I do, let's say, a 30 second stretch on one leg, and then I switch and do a 30 seconds on the other leg, and then I go back and then do it again. That'll cover my hamstrings. Same scenario with my quads. If you work more body parts, make sure you give them each the same degree of attention. So 1 minute, I break it down typically into two 30 second segments. What happens sometime with stretching, you also temporarily reduce the amount of blood flow while you're stretching those muscles. That's why it's good to kind of do one side for 30 seconds, go to the other side, and then come back and do it again. But absolutely, make sure you stretch and or mobilize on a regular basis. Tip number 9, you've absolutely got to get in sleep. You've got to sleep. And I don't mean 2-3 hours a night. You've got to get in a decent duration of sleep so your muscles have time to recover, repair, rebuild. Keep in mind, we don't get bigger and stronger when we're at the gym. It happens during that recovery process. So make certain that you're getting adequate amounts of rest. I see a lot of people who overlook this. It doesn't mean that you can't accomplish your goals without getting plenty of rest, but what it means is you're going to prolong that duration. So whereas maybe it would take you a month and a half to lose 10 pounds, you may stretch that out to 4 months because you're not sleeping well, then you're not eating well, and then you've got other things going on in your body that aren't helpful. Number 10, nourishment. You've absolutely got to take pride in what you're consuming. You know, there's a saying that we often use, you cannot out-train bad eating habits. And what that essentially says is you can work out 6 days a week, 7 days a week, heck, 8 days a week if there was a such thing as that. But if you've got crappy eating habits, you're not going to come anywhere near getting the results that you truly could. So make certain that your nutrition is on point. Make sure that you're hydrating adequately. By doing these things, not only do you strengthen your body, you strengthen your cells, you're going to feel better, you're going to have more energy, it's going to be easier for you to get into the zone, and you're going to have a great workout. Those 10 tips alone will make a significant difference in terms of your fitness journey and how long it takes you to get there. Don't spend 12 months trying to reach a goal that you could have achieved in 6 months by just following these 10 tips. My name is Steve Richardson. I appreciate you watching. Do me a favor. Don't forget to like and subscribe below. Make sure that you keep the updates on this channel turned on. So hit that bell icon. That way you will get notifications as I upload these videos. There are quite a few to come, and I look forward to serving you. Good, good, good. Get going. 2. One. Last one. Last one. Down.